Linear equations in two variables. Graphical representation and word problems. How many lines can pass through a point? Infinite. How many lines can pass through two points? One and only one. Very good. Now, keep this in mind before we revise some more concepts to get you ready to draw graphs of linear equations in two variables. If the coordinates of a point are given to you, you know how to plot the point on a graph. Let's quickly revise this. Plot the following points on the graph. A33, B4-1, C06, D70, E-26, F-8-8. When the coordinates of a point are given, the first value is the distance from the x-axis and the second value is the distance from the y-axis. Let's consider the first point. We mark the distance from the x-axis first. Then, we mark the distance from the y-axis and see where the lines intersect. That gives us the first point. We mark the point and label it. This is how we mark all the other points too. If you are asked to draw the graph of a certain linear equation in two variables, what will you do? You will need to find the points that you need to plot on the graph. How many points will you need? To draw a line, we need two points. So, we need to find two solutions to the equation first. Then, plot the points and draw the line. And that's it. Plot the graph for the equation y is equal to 2x plus 1. Step 1. Finding two solutions. If x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2 into 0 plus 1. Therefore, y is equal to 0 plus 1 and hence the coordinates are 0, 1. If x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2 into 2 plus 1. Therefore, y is equal to 4 plus 1 and hence the coordinates are 2, 5. Step 2. Plot these points on the graph. Point A, 0, 1 and point B, 2, 5. Join these points to form a line. Plot the graph for the equation x is equal to 2y minus 3. Step 1. Finding two solutions. If y is equal to 0, x is equal to 2 into 0 minus 3. Therefore, x is equal to minus 3. And hence the coordinates are minus 3 and 0. If y is equal to 2, x is equal to 2 into 2 minus 3. Therefore, x is equal to 4 minus 3, which is equal to 1. And hence the coordinates are 1 and 2. Step 2. Plot these points on the graph. Point A, minus 3, 0 and point B, 1, 2. Step 3. Join these points to form a line. Plot the graph for the equation x minus y is equal to 5. Step 1. Finding two solutions. If x is equal to 0, y is equal to minus 5. If y is equal to 0, x is equal to 5. Step 2. Plot these points on the graph. Point A, 0 minus 5 and point B, 5, 0. Step 3. Join these points to form a line. Find the equation of the lines passing through the point 1, 2. Let us first mark the point. Infinite lines pass through a point. Let's have one that passes through the point and the origin. Let's write the coordinates of some points on this line. X0, Y0, X1, Y2, X2, Y4, X3, Y6. What could the equation be? Y is equal to 2x or 2x minus y is equal to 0. Find the equation of the lines passing through the point 1, 2. Consider any equation which can be true when x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. One possible equation is y is equal to x plus 1. Let's see what values of x and y we get with this equation. x0y1, x1y2, x2y3, x3y4. Let's plot these points on a graph. Let us mark these points. Draw a line passing through these points. And that's how we get the equations of any two lines passing through the point 1, 2. Y is equal to x plus 1. That is the second line passing through the point. And here's the first one we plotted. Find the equation of any two lines passing through the point 2, 10. Consider any equation which can be true when x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 10. One possible equation is y is equal to x plus 8. Let's see what values of x and y we get with this equation. x0, y8, x1, y9, x2, y10, x minus 1, y7. Let's plot these points on a graph. Let us mark these points. Draw a line passing through these points. Y is equal to x plus 8. Now let's try another one. Consider any other equation which can be true when x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 10. One possible equation is y is equal to 5x. Let's see what values of x and y we get with this equation. x2, y10, x1, y5, x0, y0, x minus 1, y minus 5. Let's plot these points on a graph. Let us mark these points. Draw a line passing through these points. Y is equal to 5x. And let's mark the first line too. Y is equal to x plus 8. Now, let's have a look at word problems. The monthly hostel charge for Radha is rupees 1000 per month and an extra rupees 50 per day for meals. Form a linear equation in two variables to show this situation for a month. Try to see this now. Radha has to pay rupees 1000 anyway. So, her charges are going to be rupees 1000 plus food charge. Her per day food charge is rupees 50. So, if she eats for F days, she has to pay 50 into F. If the total monthly charge is T, then T is equal to 1000 plus 50F. And that is our linear equation in two variables. Let's take a look at another one. The cost of a toy telephone is same as the cost of 4 balls. Express the statement as a linear equation in two variables. Also find the cost of getting 2 toy telephones packed if cost of 1 ball is rupees 5 and there is a fixed cost of rupees 2 for packing a toy telephone. Consider the first part. Cost of a phone is equal to P. Cost of a ball is equal to B. Therefore, P is equal to 4 into B. Therefore, P minus 4B is equal to 0. Let's consider the second part of the problem. We already know phone cost is equal to P, ball cost is equal to B, and P is equal to 4B. It is given that B is equal to rupees 5. So, P is equal to 4 into 5, which is equal to rupees 20. Packing cost per phone is rupees 2. packing 2 phones is equal to rupees 2 into 2, which is equal to rupees 4. Total cost is equal to rupees 20 into 2 plus 4, which is equal to rupees 44. Let's take a look at another one. A taxi charges rupees 20 for the first kilometer and then rupees 12 per kilometer. If the total distance covered is D and the fare is F, write a linear equation showing the relationship. Try to see this now. Total charge is equal to first kilometer charge plus rest of kilometer charge, which is equal to 20 plus D minus 1 into 12. Therefore, F is equal to 20 plus D minus 1 into 12. Rest of the kilometers is equal to total distance minus first kilometer. Therefore, rest of the kilometers is equal to D minus 1. So, F is equal to 20 plus 12 into D minus 1. Let's plot this. When D is 1, F is 20. When D is 2, F is 32. When D is 3, F is 44. When D is 4, F is 56. When D is 5, F is 68. Did you understand how to represent a linear equation in two variables graphically? Yes? Good job!
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.